Investigators have successfully located the missing door from Alaska Airlines that became detached mid-air on January 5th. The search for the door plug-in, Portland, the departure city of the Boeing 737 MAX 9 involved in the mid-air incident, has concluded with the discovery of the door. A schoolteacher identified as Bob has discovered the missing door from Alaska Airlines in his yard, announced the chair of the organization leading the investigation on Monday. Subsequently, National Transportation Safety Board Chair Jennifer Homendy expressed excitement during a press conference, stating, "I am excited to announce that we found the door plug." Homendy acknowledged and thanked the resident, Bob, who shared two photos of the item with the NTSB. She added, "We are going to pick that up and ensure that we begin analyzing it." As the first day of the NTSB's investigation concluded, the agency's chairperson highlighted certain complications impeding the process. Notably, the event record on the plane's cockpit voice recorder had been inadvertently overwritten and the door plug had not been located. Expressing disappointment during a press conference on Sunday night, Chairperson Homendy remarked, "That is unfortunately a loss for us." She emphasized that this loss of voice data is a setback for safety. Homendy advocated for extending the minimum recording time on these devices from 2 hours to 25 hours, a measure that could enhance the likelihood of preserving cockpit voice data in the event of such accidents. Speaking about the communication issues and chaos on board the Boeing 737 MAX 9, she said that the flight crew reported hearing a loud noise and the cabin depressurized rapidly as the door blew out. Airlines and safety bodies around the world grounded some versions of the Boeing 737 MAX 9 jets pending inspections, with dozens of flights cancelled after the incident. The Federal Aviation Administration has mandated immediate inspections for specific Boeing 737 MAX 9 planes before they can resume flight, affecting around 171 aircraft globally. Each inspection is expected to take 4 to 8 hours. Major carriers, including US-based Alaska and United Airlines, have grounded their MAX 9 planes for inspection. Smaller fleets like Turkish Airlines have followed suit. Boeing, having delivered approximately 218 of the 737 MAX planes worldwide, acknowledged the impact on the affected carriers. The incident involving Alaska Flight 1282 departing from Portland International Airport prompted a quick return due to a reported pressurization issue. Fortunately, there were no major injuries. Image shared on social media revealed a significant hole in the side panel with emergency oxygen masks deployed. Boeing has faced challenges with technical and quality control issues related to its 737 MAX models. In December, the company advised airlines to inspect MAX aircraft for loose hardware on plane rudder control systems after a missing nut was discovered during routine maintenance. The global grounding of Boeing's 737 MAX planes followed two crashes in 2018 and 2019, resulting in 346 fatalities. The FAA only approved their return to service after Boeing implemented changes to the flight control system.
Subscribe to One India channel and never miss an update.